Hi everybody, Namaskar and welcome to Curries with Pumbi. Today I will show you how to make a cauliflower curry which is cooked in a rich white gravy with a few simple ingredients. It is a popular Bengali dish called phulkopir roast. Phulkopi is cauliflower in Bengali. This is usually served at wedding parties and also during festival time. This recipe was requested by one of my subscribers as well as my friend named Pushpanjali. If you are new to my channel, then please consider subscribing by clicking on that subscribe button down below. So let's get started. I have taken 4 tablespoons of white poppy seeds, or khus as it is known in Hindi, or posto as we call in Bengali, and have soaked it in water for at least 2 hours. You can even soak it overnight, then drain the water through a strainer and put it in a blender. Now I know that poppy seeds are unavailable in many places. In that case, you can use 4 tablespoons of chopped fresh coconut, or if you do not like coconut, then just increase the number of cashew nuts, as I will be also using cashew nuts for this recipe. I had even soaked 7 to 8 unroasted cashew nuts, which I drained and added them to the poppy seeds. Break 1 green chili into half and add it, and finally half teaspoon of salt. Now add little water at a time and blend it. If you add a lot of water, then the poppy seeds won't blend well, so add little at a time while blending. Do not blend it to a fine paste, but keep it a little bit on the coarse side like this. As you can see, the paste is not too coarse, not too fine, and the consistency should not be too thin as well, so add just a little water while blending. Now take 3 tablespoons of plain yogurt or curd in a bowl and whisk or stir very well. This prevents the yogurt from curdling when it hits the hot pan, so always stir or whisk the yogurt before adding it to the hot pan. Next, I grated about a 2-inch piece of ginger. I have taken a cauliflower, but since it is huge, I will be using only half of it. I have given all the ingredient proportions in the description box below, so please check out for that. I cut the florets into medium-sized pieces and washed them well. In a pan, I heated about 3 tablespoons of mustard oil on high heat. I'm a great fan of mustard oil, but you can use any oil of your choice. Once the oil starts smoking, reduce the heat to low and add the cauliflower florets slowly. Be very careful here as the oil jumps up once that wet cauliflower hits the hot oil. So let the cauliflower drain for some time after washing and decrease the heat to low while adding them. After that, again increase the heat to medium-high and fry them. Fry till they turn golden brown. This will take about 5 to 6 minutes. Though it is called phulkopir roast, I just cannot figure out why this dish got such a name, as there is nothing of roasting here. But I did stick to the traditional name. I would call it more of a Shahi recipe, as cashew nuts are used. Let me know in the comment section below if you know why it is called as phulkopir roast. Take out the cauliflower once they turn a little brown. Next, in that same pan, add a tablespoon of oil, and then I added a teaspoon of my homemade ghee. Let the ghee melt on medium heat. I have taken 1 dry bay leaf, 1 inch length cinnamon stick, and 5 green cardamoms. Always crack open the green cardamoms before adding them, or else they burst open on coming in contact with the hot oil, and that is no fun at all. Then add the grated ginger, fry on low heat for a minute. After that, add about half a teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder or paprika, or if you like that heat, then add red chili powder. Remember, the heat should be very low at this point, or else the chili powder will burn. Stir for a second and immediately add a splash of water so that it doesn't burn. Then add the plain yogurt. Remember to stir the yogurt very well before adding. At the same time, the heat will remain very low at this time, or else the yogurt will curdle, and immediately after adding it, start stirring. Then comes the poppy seed and cashew paste. I added little water to my blender jar to get the last bit of the paste. Now you can increase the heat to medium and stir for about 2 to 3 minutes. I switched to a wooden spoon now. The gravy has been well fried and it is bubbling, so add about a cup of water. Then comes 1 teaspoon of salt and 1 teaspoon of sugar. Sugar is optional and you can leave it out if you have any concerns, but this dish has a little bit of sweetness to it. Now add the fried cauliflower and stir it on medium heat. Once the gravy comes up to a boil, cover it on low heat for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, uncover and add 1/4 of a cup of green peas. I have used frozen peas, but if fresh green peas are available where you live, then certainly use them. I added 2 whole green chilies and again covered it on low heat for another 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, let's see what's happening in that pan. The cauliflower is nearly done, but it needs a few more minutes, so I covered for another 3 minutes. After 3 minutes, the cauliflower has reached that right amount of softness. Do not let it turn too soft and mushy, they should still hold their shape. We can remove the bay leaf now as it has rendered out all its flavor and its job is over. Serve this with pulao, rice or roti. Please do not forget to hit that subscribe button down below. Thanks for watching. Eat healthy and stay healthy. Bye bye.